Coach Brewer, your team gets to finally come home this weekend. Be hosting the Comfort Inn & Suites Classic with a couple of teams in. Open up Friday with a doubleheader against Oakland. Talk a little bit about your team, and I know that consistency is probably a word that would come up with your team last weekend. Not the greatest results, but talk about coming home, getting into a routine at home here, and a little bit about some of the teams this weekend.
Yeah, last weekend, you know, another long trip to close out February, going to UNC Greensboro. Great facilities, great host. Brought some big teams into that tournament, Minnesota being one of them. Kansas, they're getting a lot of top 25 votes. Just two nice-looking ball clubs. Talk about inconsistency. You know, we handle UNC Greensboro 13-1. They helped a little bit with their inconsistent pitching, but we also put some numbers on the board ourselves. So very happy with the 13-1 game. The next day, we turn around and lose to them 3-2. So that's just inconsistency. Different girl in the circle, different game. It's the same team. So I was a little disappointed with our lack of consistency that weekend as well. I agree with you. As far as this upcoming weekend, February is long for us. I go to three long tournaments, leaving on Thursday, coming home on late Sunday. So we're looking forward to playing at home, opening up in March here at our own facility, sleeping in our own bed, hosting some teams. So I hope that we can have some consistency. I've seen signs of great offense, great signs of great defense, not usually in the same game, unfortunately. So we're hoping to kind of show our family and friends kind of what we've been working on in February, and hope I see a little bit of different team in my own team.
What does it mean to play at home? You hit on the routine, but just being able to know that you're in your home facility, you got to kind of protect your home facility. You do have some good teams coming in too, though.
Absolutely. You know, we're taking Oakland University on in a doubleheader on Friday to kind of open up and give them a couple games. They just had a new head coach be assigned to them late this summer, so she's an intense coach. She comes from a good program. They always give us a couple games. IUPUI from Indianapolis is coming over, as well as Bowling Green from Ohio. So definitely a nice little tournament we're hosting. Hopefully the weather holds and we have a chance to showcase a little bit. What does it mean to play at home? Everything. You know, to take pride in your facility, take pride in your campus, take pride in your college, play in front of your family and friends who maybe don't get the opportunity to travel south like we get to. So this is a huge weekend for us, not only to show our fans, but kind of prove to ourselves that we had a rough start. Being 4-10 is nothing to be proud of, but it's also nothing to hang your head about. We've played some tough competition. We're a different team now in the beginning of March than we were in the beginning of February.
You've got conference starting next weekend after this weekend's tournament. Talk about what it'll mean to get into, as we've hit on that consistency term here today, but talk about what it will mean to, you know, get a full weekend of, you know, all good games in, because conference starts next weekend, and once conference starts, you've got to be on top of your game every single game.
Absolutely, and I think that's why you play some tough games. You play a busy schedule in February and early March just to kind of get used to the tedious repetitions of games come midweek games, come every conference game, every weekend. You do have to be sharp. We have to be consistent, and that's something we try to find in February for March. This is kind of our last hurrah before we start conference play. We start conference play in a week and a half, and that scares me a little bit due to the fact that we have been a little inconsistent. So we need this last weekend to kind of tie up some loose ends. And with playing at home, with playing in a tournament, with hosting a tournament, with weather coming in, there's a lot of distractions. So this weekend will kind of test my girls on how they handle those distractions and getting ready for conference play. And that's what it's all about, getting ready for conference. It doesn't matter the record you have prior to. It matters what you have during conference. So this is kind of our last weekend to tie up some loose ends and to get ready for conference play, hosting Austin Peay at home on April the 12th.
Talk a little bit offensively. What have you seen out of our lineup so far? A couple of kids are hitting, you know, over 300, and then you've got some a little bit lower that have been, you know, above 300 consistently over their careers. But What are you going to need to see out of your offense this weekend?
You know, Rebecca Butler and Amber Riddle had good weekends. It's hard to say good weekends when you come back 1-4, but I think they found their groove offensively. They had better quality at-bats and better outcomes. It's going to take them a while to get, you know, to stay in the 300s. They started off in the low ones and the low twos, so they had a good weekend. We're going to need those two kids to produce for us. Kayla Ashbrook didn't have the best weekend. She flourished in the first two weekends in February, kind of stumbled a little bit this past weekend, but Kayla Ashbrook's been a big leader for us offensively. Elizabeth Wagner had a good weekend. Again, not a great weekend. I think she's capable of more, but I would say those are probably our top four hitters. Stephanie Etter, a freshman, had a double off the wall to kind of get us a little bit of a spark in UNC Greensboro. She's kind of been a big hitter for us. So we need our top four, five, or six to produce. Offensively, we need to do more. We need to have back-to-back hits. We need to get more kids on. We need to lessen our LOBs and kind of get our left on base at home somehow. So our offense needs to be consistent. They need to be steady, and they need to be thick 1 through 10 through the lineup.
I was going to say, it seems like you're getting a double here or there, a triple, or a couple of stolen bases, and then you might get a couple people on with no outs, but it talk about producing runs and executing on offense.
Absolutely, and that's what we kind of missed in the first couple weekends from Kayla Ashbrook compared to last weekend. She was leading the team in RBIs, and I think Amber Riddle's up there now leading the team. When the going gets tough and there's pressure on with two outs and bases loaded or a couple runners on, we need a kid to come up with some big hits. And that's what I call big players, who take the challenge. You know that it's up to them. It's not up to the next kid if there's only one out. It's up to that kid to handle that. And that's just something we've been lacking. Like you said, we'll come up with double-digit hits, if not close to double-digit hits every game, 8-10 hits a game. That's great. The problem is they come one an inning or one and a half an inning. So we need to be consistent in producing runs. And if it's one big inning, I'll take one big inning. But we need to do a better job of getting kids to cross the plate in each inning.
Coach, good luck this weekend. Thank you.
Thank you.